Shia took from that video claiming that Shamsi is lying. Because Shamsi one of the said, things that he was still a tank, I said, you're Rafidi. He was still a tank, I said, as a Rafidi.
The followers
I take it back would have been that. And I mean, yes, these evil people, some
I would
of
say
them.
It's infallible. I would say he doesn't make no mistakes. He's from our squad.
There's no problem with that.
Our time.
You see,
exchanging the gifts. There's no problem with that.
Dul Khuwaisir Tamimi, he's the one who spoke
out. Umar Khattab had two garments and one of the companies
advised the Muslim leader, take him by hand, even if he beats you or not, if he beats you, take you well,
and smile with them, joke. I'm not saying fight them, but you boycott them.
I know it's because we're not here to get you more viewers. We are here to
talk about the brother times.
I hope it's a da'wah.
You know, call it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Alhamdulillah wa kafa wa salatu wa salamu ala abdihi al-Mustafa wa ala alihi wa sahabatihi ajma'in wa man bihadihi iqtafa wa sallama tasliman kathira. I did clarify it with Leon. The reason I did it, because Leon, he put out a video with this brother Ryan, okay? There's one thing which Shia took from that video, claiming that Shamsi is lying, because Shamsi said he's a Rafidi, then he denied it. If you listen to the whole video, clearly as a Rafidi. But one of the things that he was sleeping with the tank, I said, you're a Rafidi. He was sleeping with the tank, I said, as a Rafidi. Which I take it back without any doubt. And I'm free from that. And because, as I've mentioned, we looked at the context of the video, clearly a few times I referred to him as a Rafidi. Where is the way of the Rafida? They are too emotion. But to be honest, this man, for him to be sitting with a Shia, with a Rafida, especially the followers of Yasser Habith, yes, these evil people, sit with them, laughing with them, joking with them, calling them smart, or calling Ummina Aisha munafiqa or kadaba, a'udhu billahi min dhalik. Allah exposed you. Because you come speakers, corner speaking about Sheikh Rabi Hafidhahu Ta'ala, one of the major scholars of our time. I'm not saying he's infallible. I'm not saying he doesn't make no mistakes. He's from our scholars, from the imam of our time. You speak ill of him, and you speak ill of the Muslim leaders of Saudi. Saudi is a country that I love without any doubt. A country that helped the Muslims, but they're not perfect. I'm not saying whatever they do is perfect. No, but they are a country that helped the Muslims. Wallahi, they have a lot of khair. The Quran that you read, all of us read, is a mashaf that has been printed by Dawla Saudiya. You see? This one thing about this brother, I forgot his name anyway. We don't mention his name. Ryan is. So, I was speaking to you about the issue of takfir, or the issue of speaking against the Muslim leaders. Wallahi, I'm not trying to defend any leader, the oppressor. I'm free from that. But I'm saying let us deal with it the way the Quran and the Sunnah and the Salaf understood it. And how Prophet Muhammad told us to deal with the Muslim leaders. Because wallah is aib. Some of us in the kuffar countries, paying them paying tax and everything, then you start saying, our Muslims, they're giving money to the kuffar. But you give it to them as well. It's halal for you, haram for them? If I tell you that, you're going to tell me, no, it's exception. Like, what is exception? It's halal to do business with them. You know? It's halal to do other things with them. Prophet did business with the kuffar, with the Yahud, with the Christians. There's no problem with that. You see, exchanging the gifts. There's no problem with that. But I'm not going to justify every action they do. But it is not from the way of Al-Sunnah to come and start criticizing them openly. Because the Messenger of Allah said, if you have something for your leader, go to him, take him by hand, advise him. If he does listen, Alhamdulillah. If he doesn't, you've done your duty. As for coming to the minbar, going to the news, going to a newspaper, mention the mistakes of the leaders, that is not the way. Because who started that? Abdullah ibn Saba al-Himyari, al-Yahudi. Who started that? He's the one who, not before that, Dul Khuwaisir al-Tamimi, he's the one who spoke out against Prophet Muhammad openly. Believe it, Prophet made mistakes, wal-Iyadu Billah. Then who? Abdullah ibn Saba. It's not the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not the way of the companions. As for those narrations of some of these so-called du'at, misguided ones, one of them passed away, he mentioned the narration that Umar ibn Khattab had two garments and one of the companions said, we will never listen to you, hear and obey until you tell us how come you wearing two garments. That is not authentic narration. That Tabari mentioned without any isnad. The other one, they told Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, we will make you straight with this sword. Again, it's not. You see, that is not. Because we have clear a hadith that you advise the Muslim leader, take him by hand, even if he beats you or not, if he beats you, take your wealth, you hear and obey. A person might say, are you telling us Shamsi to be a coward? No, Prophet Muhammad never would tell us that. Because Prophet knows he doesn't speak from his own desires, he speaks from the revelation. He knows that if I'm going to rebel against the leader, and the other brother going to rebel against the leader, and the other brother, the other sister, and all of us, what is going to happen? We're going to cause more harm than the harm of the leader himself. So it's better to be patient and to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and rectify ourselves, and the victory will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Hassan al-Basri, when he saw a group of people try to remove a harm with the sword, he said they rushed
to the swords, they will remain with the swords. That's why second place now, fitna over fitna. I hope that is clear. And Allah expose that man anyway. You see what I'm saying? We don't sit with them, smile with them, joke. I'm not saying fight them, but you boycott them. They are not speak ill of the Prophet Muhammad and he's jahil, he doesn't have ilm. They will move with him. Man is going to Google and try to find answers. Embarrassing us. And I don't know, brother, this general advice to my Muslim brothers here, Allah bless you all, those who record. Ikhwa, don't record everyone. And don't bring someone jail to speak about the deen of Allah to someone who has some shubuhat. Don't do that, ikhwa. We're not here for entertainment. We're not here to get you more viewers. We are here, inshallah, the brothers. I hope they are here to spread the truth. Don't do that, my brothers. Allah bless you all. Will I be aware? It's not entertainment. I mentioned that many times. It's a da'wah. You know, it's a calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hope that is clear. Inshallah, another time we'll make another video, clarify more in details. Subhanaka Allah bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa usalli wa usallim wa ubarik ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahabati ajma'in.